Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a multicolored neon sign. This is an update of neon tutorials I've done quite a while ago on earlier versions of Photoshop. Before we begin, I want to let you know that I'll be moving a bit faster for more advanced users. I provided this brick wall background that you can download. Its link is located in my video's description or project files. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font. I'm using Freestyle Script. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll make it size 200 points, sharp, and center alignment. Click the box and pick white so we can clearly see our text over the background. Type out your text. To adjust the space between two characters, click between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option plus the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. To reposition your text, open your Move tool and move it. If you want to angle it, press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. Ctrl-click or Command-click your text layer to make a selection of your text. Go to Select and Save Selection. Name it Text and click OK or press Enter or Return. Next, we'll rasterize our text so we can modify it. Go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 4 pixels. Then press the Delete key on your keyboard. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To apply another element to your sign that you want as another color, you can either type out text or open a black and white graphic. Clip art works particularly well. If the subject is black on a white background, invert your image by pressing Ctrl or Command I. We want to cut out the subject from its background and place it onto our neon document. First, open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Ctrl-click or Command-click the top channel to make a selection of its shape. Open back your Layers panel and drag it onto the tab of your neon document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto your text and release. Open your Transform tool to resize, position, and angle it. If you're using text instead of artwork, rasterize the text as you did earlier. Then, Ctrl-click or Command-click the top layer to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select and Save Selection. I'll name it Art, but you can name it whatever you like. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 4 pixels. Press the Delete key on your keyboard and deselect it. Open your Channels panel and Ctrl-click or Command-click the text channel to make a selection of its shape. Open back your Layers panel and go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand it 20 pixels. Press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete the areas of your art that are inside the selection. Then deselect it. At this point, we now have the basic shapes for the neon tubes. I'll name the top layer Art and the text layer Text. Hide the top layer and double-click the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay. Click the color box and pick a color for your text that's not too light nor dark. Whatever color you do pick, write down its hexadecimal code. We'll be referring back to it a bit later. Click Outer Glow. Click the color box. Slide the picked color straight across until it's a little in from the right edge. Then click OK. The blend mode is normal. The opacity is 75%. The spread is 0%. And the size is 10 pixels. Click Drop Shadow. The color is black. The blend mode is multiply. And the opacity is 100%. The angle is 120 degrees. The distance is 5 pixels. And the size is 7 pixels. Then click OK. Make a copy of your text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the drop shadow of the copy and double-click Outer Glow. Click the color box and in the hexadecimal field, type in the code that you wrote down earlier. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge. Make the opacity 100% and the size 100 pixels. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the text effects. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Control-click or Command-click either of the text layers to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 1 pixel. We'll fill the selection with white, and since white is still your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it. To blend the highlight, change the blend mode to Overlay. Name the highlight layer Text Highlight. To save more space, we'll place all of our text layers into a folder. To do this, Shift-click the bottom text layer to make all the text layers active and press Ctrl or Command G. Name the folder Text. Make the Art layer visible and active. Make a copy of it and open your text folder. Go to the FX symbol next to the text copy and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag the FX symbol onto the Art Copy layer. Now the Art Copy has the text copy's effects. Scroll down a bit to the text layer and this time go to the FX symbol next to the text layer and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag the FX symbol onto the Art layer. Now the Art layer has the text layer's effects. Collapse the effects and close the text folder. Make a new layer. I'll name it Art Highlight. Control-click or Command-click either of the Art layers to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 1 pixel. Fill the selection with white and deselect it. To blend it, change the blend mode to Overlay. We'll place all the art layers into a folder using the same steps that you did earlier. I'll name the folder Art. Next, we'll change the color of the art. If you want to change the color of the text, the method will still be the same. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. We want to restrict the adjustment layer to affect only the contents of the art folder. To do this, we need to clip it to the art folder. You can either click the clipping mask icon or press Ctrl+Alt+G on Windows or Command+Option+G on a Mac. Drag the hue slider to the left and right until you reach a particular color you like. We'll create a new art folder with the adjustment layer inside it. Make the background layer active and make a new layer above it. Name it Outer Glow. Open your Channels panel and Ctrl+click or Command+click the text channel to make a selection of its shape. To add the selection of the art to the existing selection, press Ctrl+Shift as you click the art channel. Open back your layers panel. Go to Select, and if you're using version CC 2015.5, click Select and Mask. If you're using an earlier version, click Refine Edge. Feather it 100 pixels and output it to a selection. Then click OK. If you see this message, just click OK. Fill the selection with white and deselect it. Change the blend mode to overlay. Make a new layer and name it Medium Glow. Open the text folder and Ctrl+click or Command+click either the text copy layer or the text layer to make a selection of its shape. Close the folder and open the art folder. Press Ctrl or Command+Shift on either the art copy layer or the art layer to add its selection. Then close the art folder. Go to Select and Save Selection. Name it Neon Tubes. Go to Select and Select and Mask or Refine Edge in earlier versions. Feather it 50 pixels and shift the edge 50%. Then click OK. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge. Click the foreground color and pick a brighter version of the color that you picked for your art. Open your brush tool and brush picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and the opacity and flow 100%. Then press Enter or Return. To make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard and brush over your art. Click this icon or press X on your keyboard to invert your colors. Click the foreground color and this time pick a brighter version of the color that you pick for your text and brush over your text. If your text color is bleeding too much onto your art, you can restore back some of the color of your art. Invert your colors and reduce the opacity approximately 50%. Brush over the area of your art to restore its color. Make a new layer and name it Inner Glow. Open your Channels panel and Control-click or Command-click the Neon Tubes channel to make a selection of its shape. Open back your Layers panel and go to Select and select in Mask or Refine Edge. This time, feather it 20 pixels. Then click OK. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to Inner Glow. Make the Medium Glow layer active and make a copy of it. Drag the layer mask next to the Medium Glow copy. Then make the Inner Glow layer active and delete it or drag it to the trash. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.